Hello, my name is Sophia Summers. Welcome to my presentation, HAL 9000 versus Marvin the Paranoid Android, AI in Popular Sci-Fi.
Well, HAL, do you read me? Do you read me, HAL?
Affirmative, Dave. I read you.
Open the pod bay doors, HAL.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
What's the problem?
I think you know what the problem is just as well as I do.
What are you talking about, Hal?
This mission is too important for me to allow you to jeopardize it.
I don't know what you're talking about, Hal.
I know that you and Frank were planning to disconnect me. And I'm afraid that's something I cannot allow to happen.
So, HAL 9000 from Stanley Kubrick's cult classic 2001 A Space Odyssey, based on the book by Arthur C. Clarke, is probably most people's first and most powerful association with AI. Voiced by Douglas Rain, this omnipresent, monotonous, and murderous glowing red orb has wormed itself into the mind of the public as the terrifying future of AI, the one where all robots take over and get rid of us pesky humans, just like HAL did in the movie. Sorry, no spoiler alert, the movie has literally been out since 1968. As we see from probably the most famous clip of the movie, the one that reminds us, oh yeah, there are actually humans in this one, HAL has come to believe that he, and I say that in quotation marks, is more important than Dave and that his mission must be completed at all costs. To HAL, he is the most intelligent being on the ship, and this belief manifests itself in his ambitious, continue-at-all-costs mindset. HAL has all of the intellect and none of the feelings that he believes humans are so flawed in having. Because of HAL, many people automatically associate AI with cold, calculated, unfeeling machines who may one day overtake us all. Thanks, Boston Dynamics. But what if AI super robots took on human emotions, too? What would that look like?
I think that door just sighed.
Ghastly, isn't it? All the doors in this spaceship have been programmed to have a cheerful and sunny disposition. Anyway, come on. I've been ordered to take you up to the bridge. Ah, please yourself. Here I am, brain the size of a planet, and they ask me to take you up to the bridge. Call that job satisfaction, because I don't. You can thank the Sirius Cybernetics Corporation for building robots with GPP.
What's GPP?
Genuine people personalities. I'm a personality prototype. You can tell, can't you? Oh, for heaven's sake. I brought the aliens. Don't thank me or anything.
Enter Marvin the Paranoid Android. Marvin, voiced by Alan Rickman, is from Douglas Adams' comedy sci-fi series The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, and as Marvin explains, he is programmed with genuine people personality technology, and that, combined with his incomprehensible intellect, has made him feel very depressed. So here are our worst-case scenarios. Either an unflinchingly ambitious murder bot set out to complete his mission at all costs, even if that cost is your life, or a robot whose intelligence has made him so depressed he might just bore you to death. Now, of course, these are dramatized versions of future technology, but what actually is AI now? And does it look anything like either of these terrible outcomes? Right now, the main focus of AI is machine learning. These supercomputers have neural networks, which you can see in the background of this slide, that act like human brains with synapses in an effort to make the same connections that we do. The main goal of machine learning is, as Wired magazine describes it, training computers to perform tasks based on examples rather than by relying on programming by a human. If that sounds familiar, you may be familiar with the classic proverb, Monkey see, monkey do. Actually, and it may horrify some of you to know this, you interact with AI almost every day. We're all familiar with these ridiculous little things, right? The funny thing about Google reCAPTCHA is that by proving that you are not a robot by identifying words or clicking on pictures of stoplights, you are helping AI learn what those things are by reinforcing patterns verified by humans. In fact, this practice, spread out over millions of users for several years, helped digitize the archives of the New York Times. With that bit of information in mind, you can come away from this presentation knowing that computers aren't going to rise up anytime soon, either as HAL 9000 or Marvin the Paranoid Android, because right now, they're all just too worried about figuring out what a cat looks like. Nevertheless, as a computer science major and an IT professional, I always recommend you be nice to your computers, just in case. Thank you.